Hello and welcome. With the sudden fall of Ryujinx and the Sudachi developer already expressing his intention to stop working on the project, we are left wondering, how will we play the new games that will be released in the future? Especially with a new firmware on the way. The answer to this question may come directly from the dark web, with a project we've mentioned before, Torzu. Many, like myself, still don't fully trust this project. That's why I selected a few games to test and see if Torzu truly performs better than Sudachi, considering it brings unique fixes that aren't yet present in Sudachi. But before we dive into the tests, let's talk a bit about both projects. Torzu is developed on Git, even with a version available on the Surface Web. However, its development takes place on the dark web. The advantage of this is that, until Nintendo discovers who's behind the project, they can't sue or issue a cease and desist order, as they did with Ryujinx. The project initially was entirely developed on the Surface Web, but the developer decided to stop responding to commits, claiming he was dedicating too much time to the project when it was supposed to be something just for fun. He then decided to focus on developing his blog, and with that, interest in the project dropped significantly. Like Sudachi, Torzu is developed by a single person. A key difference is that Torzu allows for private network play, which was previously supported by Yuzu, without the need for manual configuration, something that's native to Torzu. At the moment, the project releases new builds for Windows, Linux, and Android. On the other hand, Sudachi, whose developer has recently been involved in various controversies, went a while without updates, leading many to believe the project was abandoned. I myself had doubts. However, in recent weeks, Sudachi received several updates that fixed issues related to installing content like DLCs, updates, mods, and cheats. Still, in the latest version, 1.0.11, I noticed some problems. For example, I couldn't launch Zelda Breath of the Wild or Red Dead Redemption. It's possible that other games are facing issues too. That's why I reverted to version 1.0.10, which worked perfectly, and that's what I'll be using for these tests. Before we begin, I ask you to leave a like to help the video reach more people. If this is your first time on the channel, consider subscribing for more videos like this. All tests were conducted with the same configurations, mods, and updates to ensure fairness in the results. FPS was unlocked to see the limit of each project. Without further ado, let's get to the tests. The first game tested was Bayonetta 3. Here, I used a resolution patch, general graphical improvements, and a patch that renders the game at 900p. From there, I doubled the internal resolution, so the gameplay you're watching on both projects is actually running at 1800p. In the gameplay, the visual difference is minimal, but already in the first game, we had a huge FPS difference on Sudachi's part. At many points, it delivered double the FPS compared to Torzu. I don't think we'll see such a significant difference in the upcoming tests. Perhaps this discrepancy was caused by the resolution increase, where Sudachi seemed more prepared. Additionally, RAM usage was almost 1 GB higher on Torzu. Check out the results on the screen. Our second test was with Red Dead Redemption, a game coming to PC but priced higher than Red Dead Redemption 2, which is a much newer game. Seriously, don't buy this game at full price on PC. For our test, we used the native resolution of 1080p, along with a mod that allows us to reach up to 120fps if our hardware is capable, without speeding up the game. We rode the same path in both emulators, heading to the same destination. This time, the result was almost a tie, with a slight performance edge for Torzu, as you can see. I also tested Fire Emblem Engage since the previous issue of intense stutter while compiling shaders using the Vulkan API was a major concern. However, both projects have already resolved this issue, and now they perform almost identically in nearly every aspect. Torzu used a little more RAM and DRM, but nothing significant. I didn't detect any other performance or graphical problems. Moving on to Pokemon Scarlet, as I've mentioned several times, Ryujinx is the project where you'll get the best performance. But if your PC can only run user-based emulators, here we are to test it. In the first test, in the city, the only difference was the time of day in the game. We had almost a tie, with a slight performance advantage for Torzu, and a small increase in RAM and VRAM usage on its side. In the open field test, we took a short trip, and this time, the result was a tie. However, Torza stood out in the low 1%, indicating fewer stutters in Pokémon Scarlet. In Pokémon Sword, I tested in the open and crowded areas of the DLC. Although I couldn't follow exactly the same path in both emulators, the results were nearly identical. During battle, the FPS increased several times, but I reset the counter during battles to keep things consistent, and again, we had a tie, as you can see in the results. To test shader compilation, we used Super Smash Bros. And 8-player battles. Right at the start, Sadachi had a performance drop due to shader compilation, which gave Torzu a slight edge. However, RAM usage was higher in Torzu, as you can see in the results. In Super Mario Odyssey, we split the test into two. The first part was in the Metro Kingdom, known for being graphically heavy. We had an almost identical result. The second test was in the Cascade Kingdom, where we followed the main path, passing through areas with a lot of water particles and object destruction. Again, the result was identical, with a slight edge for Sadachi, as we'll see next. Now, talking about The Witcher 3, which in my opinion is the best game ever made, and if you disagree, you're wrong. I know this game has an excellent version for PC, and it's worth testing the Switch version if you don't have a powerful PC. In a short run, we again had a tie between both projects. The game still has several issues, like ground textures rendering weirdly, something present in both emulators. Keep in mind that this game was never optimized for these emulators, given that there's the excellent PC version. Let's check the results. Finally, I tested Zelda Breath of the Wild, but if you want to play this title, I recommend using Cemu, which is much better optimized. The game is exactly the same, and on Cemu, you can even have superior graphical quality, with integrated mods that improve the geometry of distant objects, shadows, dynamic FPS, anti-aliasing, and much more. But going back to our test, while flying over one of the densest and heaviest cities in the game, the performance stayed above the native 30 FPS, as you can see in the results. As for Zelda Tears of the Kingdom, we split the test into two parts. In the first, in the open field, the performance was identical between the two emulators. In the second part, walking through a small village, once again the results were practically the same. Even with one of the most recent games like Tears of the Kingdom, there were no significant performance differences between Sadachi and Torzu. This shows that, despite the claims that Sadachi hasn't improved since the end of Yuzu, Torza also hasn't made significant advancements. To conclude our video, there wasn't a significant performance difference between the projects tested, except when using resolutions above 1080p, where Sadachi showed much superior performance. Now, as for which project you should use, let's look at both sides. On one hand, we have Sadachi, a reliable emulator, with many people believing its developer was quite experienced. However, this year has been full of controversy and questionable actions, including conflicts between communities, some even initiated by the developer. Despite that, focusing solely on the project itself, it remains a solid option. The biggest issue now is that, with Ryujinx out of the picture, the source for fixes has also disappeared. This could mean that even if the developer decides to continue, future improvements might be limited. On the other hand, we have Torzu, a project that fewer people trust due to its development happening outside the surface, on the dark web. Despite this, it delivered results similar to Sadachi, and its developer has already shown the ability to implement fixes without directly relying on Ryujinx. It's possible that new updates, such as implementing newer firmware, might arrive on Toiza first. However, the main concern is security, as with two almost identical projects, it's hard for users to opt for something coming from outside the surface without worrying about safety. My personal choice at the moment is Sudachi. However, you can use Toiza without issues. I'll leave links to trusted sites on the surface where you can safely download both projects without the risk of malware. That's today's video, folks. I hope I cleared up all your doubts. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.